How's it going, folks? It's Rob here. I thought I'd give you a bit of a look at the little chop and flip system, aquaponic system. I built my parents a couple of weeks back. Dad and I both built it together. Bit of family bonding. I thought I'd just run through this build in particular because it is slightly different to the other clip I've just posted on building a chop and flip system. I just wanted to give you another example of a way you can sort of tweak it just to suit your own needs. I could have run through it with the other clip, but it just would have gone on for hours. So I figured a short little one might give you a couple of ideas. So we'll pop down and we'll go through some of the finer points. So the first thing we did differently with this build compared with the other is that we took the skids off the bottom of the pallet, and this tray is actually sitting on the ground. Now the skids haven't been wasted, they've been used elsewhere in the build, but we'll get to that in a tick. What we've done with the cage is different as well. We chopped off those little extra bits of the pipework on the cage so we could just have a flat bar sit all the way around this tray on the base. Now what we've used the pallet skids for, because they're a different type, they're actually metal, we've used them as the divider between the grow bed and the fish tank. The reason being is this is a lot harder to chop up and throw in a wheelie bin than the little legs down the bottom. So I don't think the legs made it into the wheelie bin anyway. I think Dad's got them around the back for another project. But anyway, this just made use of a bit of waste that was hard to get rid of. Dad's wired it on with a bit of old clothesline wire, so it's definitely not going anywhere nice and sturdy on there. And it's sitting on top of some hardwood that I found under our house. One of the reasons why I like the idea of using this is you can see the center support there. It actually goes up and offers support right under the lid, which forms the base of the grow bed. We'll come in for a closer look, hey? So you can see the lid there. It's just sitting on that center riser. It just gives that little bit of central support, helps hold up the center of the grow bed. So it worked out really well with this pallet here. But like you saw with the other pallet, it had plastic feet, totally different design. So that's why I'm a bit hesitant and saying this is the only way you can build a system. There are a whole heap of different ways you can knock one together depending on what you have available to you. So just something I wanted to show you support wise just on the both sides, I've popped another one of these bars that holds the IBCs into the cages. I've drilled a hole and I've put the screw through, and it's acting as supports for the side. There's one on either side just to, you know, make sure that she's not going to sag too much, and it's doing a fairly good job. With the other build, what we've got is the timber pretty much all sitting on the base of the grow bed, so it doesn't really need any more support. But I thought for this one here, we'd just throw it in. We had them laying around. As far as the rest of the build goes, it's pretty much all the same. The water is very brown in there that you can see. That's because Mum and Dad have been adding in some sea salt, or it's a seaweed emulsion, and that's just adding a little bit of nutrients for the plants that are already in the grow bed. They've also been cycling the system by adding a pinch of food every day. That pinch of food, fish food, will break down and basically feed the bacteria that are naturally occurring in the environment, and setting up the biofilter on the top, which is your grow bed. So it's just a little neat trick to cycle your system. So when the fingerlings are ready to go into this system, we might pop around and I might do a little bit of a clip on just cycling the system with and without the fish. Just to show you as well, Dad's got some boards that he's making up just to go down the side on the base of the fish tank, and there'll be more that go around the top. You might be able to make out the green on some of that clay. I didn't add enough clay into this one. I didn't have enough bags. I need to add at least one more to bring the clay up a little bit further. So the standpipe was set for the 250 mil, or just under 10 inches, and it was allowing water to come up almost to the surface, just encouraging algal growth across the top. So what I've done is I've cut the standpipe down, just break the siphon there. I've cut the standpipe down so it's a little bit lower than it should be, and once I add the extra bag of clay to bring up the side a little bit further, about 20 mil or 3/4 of an inch, I can add another section of pipe in there, so just to bring that up far enough. So, but otherwise, yeah, this system's going pretty well. So I added a few more lettuce in today just to make up for the seeds that didn't germinate. Mum and I sprinkled a whole heap on the day this was set up. We padded them in, and normally that's all we do in our system and they all germinate. A couple of things were going against these poor seeds though. The grandkids were coming around and playing in the clay, so that would have dislodged a few of them. Not only that, because the water's coming up so high and then sinking down again, I think it may have dragged some of the seeds down further. So I thought I'd buy them a little punnet of lettuce just to fill out the bed a bit further. So, but they're really happy with it. I've had no complaints yet. They would like some fish in there, but I'd just really like it to have a little bit of cladding on the outside before we add the fish. So as soon as that's done, we'll get the 10 silver perch in there. Just quickly, just wanted to show you down here. So this little box down here houses the electrics. Just open him up. Basically got little rubber grommets here where the power leads come in. Makes it nice and watertight. Also stops little critters like cockroaches and lizards and whatnot getting in here. There's actually going to be an air compressor hooked up in here as well. It will be a backup one, so if the power goes out, there'll always be air in the fish tank. We'll have it running. It's got two lithium ion batteries in there, and it runs with the power on and off. It swaps over to battery, so we'll have it running full time anyway. But yeah, we'll also have it as a backup. One other thing I think Dad's done, which is great, is he's filled up the holes in all the pipe that we cut. That'll stop any rain going down there and, you know, rusting it out, accumulating down the base. Also too, it'll stop ants from setting up nests in there. Just to make it look pretty for the time being, he's put a little bit of tape on there. But once the timber cladding's on there, you're not going to see it. So might help a few of you guys out, because I have had problems with ants setting up nests in the pipework. So as you can see, this build went together a little bit differently to the other one I posted a clip on. If you haven't seen it, you can check it out in that little thumbnail there. I just needed to take into consideration a few things. It needed to be shorter for my parents, because they're a little bit shorter than myself. And also too, they didn't have the facilities to get rid of the feet that were underneath the tray that the IBC was on. So I thought I'd incorporate it into the build with this one. These little chop and flip systems are a great way to cut your teeth in aquaponics. So it might be something to think about if you're looking to build your own little system. And for you folks already contemplating a build, I hope this one may have given you a couple of ideas, or at least made you see that there are different ways you can set it up if your IBC is a little bit different to the others that you've seen around online. So if you did enjoy this clip and you want to see more of the upcoming aquaponic clips or any of the other clips we post on our small little backyard farm, you can subscribe by hitting that little button up there, and then you can check a box and you'll get email notifications every time I post a clip to YouTube, and you can come along and see what's going on in our little backyard farm or my parents or wherever we may be. I hope everyone is well and happy, and I do hope you enjoyed the clip and it's been helpful. I'll catch you next time. Cheers, folks. Bath time for the Maggies. You're all having a bit of a bath in the wok that Dad set up in the frangipani tree. He puts it there for the birds. Looks like these five here are going to finish all the water in one hit.